stunning.
Thank you.
All right, you guys. Love is a reason we're here. Stephen William Price and Rachel Lynn Pratt, you have chosen each other. And we are gathered here today in this place of natural beauty to witness our vows of love and blessings and support. And I'd like to bow our heads for a moment of prayer. God, for the joy of this occasion, we thank you. For the significance of this wedding day, we thank you. For this important moment in an ever-growing relationship, we thank you. For your presence here and now, and for your presence at all times, we thank you. Amen. So true marriage is more than the joining bonds of two persons. In its right relation, it's the uniting of two souls already attuned to each other. When such a true bond already exists between a man and a woman, it is fitting that an outer acknowledgement be made. This acknowledgement is the prime object of this gathering and this ceremony. We are here to bear witness to the entry into a closer relationship of husband and wife, of these beloved friends of 14 years who are already one in spirit. So may the meaning of this hour be fulfilled throughout the days and years to come, and may the love of this man and this woman, their unity of spirit, grow deeper and stronger as their relationship continues to grow. Let this marriage be a great and loving adventure. May your joining be a beloved journey. May you be brought together in heart, mind, and body. May you be guided in the way of happiness. May your relationship be a burst of light and a fountain of love, not just for the both of you, but for the world. And may you always remember that in each other's arms, you will find strength and happiness. So it is fitting to speak briefly about love. We live in a world of joy and fear and search for meaning and strength in the seeming disorder. We discover the truest guidelines to our search when we realize love in all its magnitude. Love is the eternal force of life. And love is the force that allows us to face fear and uncertainty with courage. Marriage also requires much of two people. Sometimes more than you feel you can give to each other. You come together from different backgrounds and experiences. In this covenant of marriage, you're not leaving these behind, but you're forming a new family, which extends your circle of love. Along with Daisy and Roscoe. Your confidence in the future brings the two of you here today. Commit yourselves to working at this relationship, so that it may always grow, enriching your lives from this moment forward. You are now taking into your care and keeping the happiness of the person in all the world whom you love best. You are adding to your life not only the affection of each other, but also the companionship and blessing of deep trust. You are agreeing to share strength, responsibilities, and love. At the end of this ceremony, legally, you will be husband and wife. But you must decide each and every day that you want to remain married. I think you guys got that. Remember to treat yourselves and each other with respect. And remind yourselves often of what brought you together. Give the highest priority to the tenderness, gentleness, and kindness that this connection deserves. When frustration, difficulty, and fear assail your relationship, as they threaten all relationships at one time or the other, remember to focus on what is right between you, not just what seems wrong. In this way, you can ride out the storms when the clouds hide the face of the sun in your lives. Remembering that even if you lose sight of the sun for a moment, it's still there. And if each of you takes responsibility for the quality of your life together. It will be marked by abundance and delight. So I'd like you to both remember in your marriage, it is the little things that are the big things. It's never being too old to hold hands. It's remembering to say, I love you, at least once a day. Well done. You guys are good students. It is having a mutual sense of values and objectives. It is standing together and facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers. It is speaking words of appreciation. It is always having a forgiving heart. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful in life. It's not only marrying the right person, it's being the right partner. This is the art of marriage. A good marriage is also friendship caught fire. It's quiet mutual confidence, sharing and forgiving. It's loyalty through good and bad times. It settles for less than perfection and makes allowances for human weaknesses. Love is content with the present, hopes for the future, and does not brood over the past. It is the day in and day out chronicles of irritations, problems, compromises, small disappointments, big victories, and working toward common goals. If you have love in your life, it can make up for a great many things that you lack. If you do not have it, no matter what else there is, it's never enough. Marriage is also a holy sacrament. And in Paul's letter to the Corinthians, he tells, when we've heard this before, love is patient and kind. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking, nor easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. It does not delight in evil, but rejoices when the truth wins out. Love never fails. So faith, hope, and love abide these three, but the greatest of these is love. And this is something that's gone for hundreds and hundreds of years, so that says it all. May the love that the two of you share today grow deeper and surer with every passing day. So you're already joining hands, so that was good. I'm gonna take it just for a second. Okay, Marina, what time do you have?
It is.
6:58. That is your time from now on, and the groom always has to remember that. 6:58 twice a day, a.m. and p.m. Because I want the two of you to remember how you feel this very moment. And as the years go on, at 6:58 twice a day, it's going to be an awesome reminder for the two of you.
It's a good time without
a pencil. Oh, that was good. But really, I do want you to remember and acknowledge this blessing that you've been given. For a love such as yours does not come to every person, nor does it make itself known every day. You are very blessed. So cherish this blessing that is your love. I pray that you come to each day with laughter and devotion in your heart, that joy always resides in your home. May you live with gentle faith and quiet grace, your home blessed with white flung doors to welcome family and friends, so the love you share will be shared with the wider world. Above all, I pray that at the end of your life's journey, you will look at one another and know that you have loved deeply, cared fully, and grown wise in the soft light of God's universe. And I found a perfect poem for you, Little Miss Orchid Girl. It's Chinese, which is very cool. It's called When Two People Are at One. When two people are at one and their inmost parts, they shatter even the strength of iron or of bronze. And when two people understand each other in their inmost parts, their words are sweet and strong like the fragrance of orchids. So that goes along with your 6:58 time. You'll have that. You will memorize. That's right. All right, Stephen. I'd like you to repeat after me to Rachel. Rachel, you are my one true love.
Rachel, you are my one true love.
I come to you with my eyes wide open.
I come to you with my eyes wide open.
I take you to be my wife.
I take you to be my wife.
Partner.
Partner.
Companion.
Companion.
And best friend.
Best friend.
All that I am.
All that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I offer to you in love and in joy.
I offer to you in love and in joy.
I promise to walk by your side.
I promise to walk by your side.
Respect you.
Respect you.
And honor you as an individual.
Honor you as an individual.
I promise to believe in you always.
I promise to believe in you always.
Wherever you go, I will go.
Wherever you go, I will go.
Whatever you face, I will face.
Whatever you face, I will face.
This is my promise.
This is my promise.
So, yeah. All right, Rachel. Repeat after me. Stephen, you are my one true love.
Stephen, you are my one true love.
I come to you with open arms.
I come to you with open arms.
I take you to be my husband.
I take you to be my husband.
Partner.
Partner.
Companion.
Companion.
And best friend.
And best friend.
All that I am.
All that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I offer to you in love and in joy.
I offer to you love and joy.
I promise to walk by your side.
I promise to walk by your side.
Respect you.
Respect you.
And honor you as an individual.
And honor you as an individual.
I promise to believe in you always.
I promise to believe in you always.
Wherever you go, I will go.
Wherever you go, I will go.
Whatever you face, I will face.
Whatever you will face, I will face.
This is my promise.
This is my promise.
Welcome. As the two of you grow in wisdom during your years together, may you have the will to do and keep these vows. So.
Yeah,
that was
kind
of
pow,
pow, pow. I know.
Yeah, she's nervous.
He doesn't like the weather.
Mm-hmm. Oh, God, love them. Okay. Rings are an ancient symbol. What? Not?
Nope.
Not.
Chill out.
Yeah. Rings are an ancient symbol. Blessed and simple. Round like the eye, round like the heart, and round like the sun. May these rings symbolize that your love, like the sun, illuminates and warms the other's heart. Like the eye, you must see clearly, even amid the adversity of life, and like arms that embrace as grace upon the world. May they also remind you that love given comes back around again and again. Now, let me take this ring and place it on Rachel's finger. Do you, Stephen, knowing this woman's love for you, and returning it, realizing her strengths and learning from them, recognizing her weaknesses and helping to overcome them, do you take Rachel to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
So repeat after me. With this ring,
with this ring,
I give you my heart.
I give you my heart.
From this day forward,
from this day forward,
you shall not walk alone.
You shall not walk alone.
Now you can take the engagement ring off if you would please. No spitting.
Drop it.
There you go. And place that one there.
We don't have to sugar yet.
Oh. Not you. That's okay. It's going to drop you there anyway.
I'll turn this place
over. I got it. All right, darling. Take this ring, Rachel. Do you, Rachel, knowing this man's love for you and returning it, realizing his strengths and learning from them, recognizing his weaknesses and helping him to overcome them, take Stephen to be your lawfully wedded husband.
I do.
And place this ring on his finger, please. And repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I give you my heart.
I give you my heart.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
You shall not walk alone.
You shall not walk alone.
Now these rings, by their shape, is a symbol of the undying love that exists between you. The substance of which is composed of the symbol of purity, which shall ever characterize your mind and hearts in your relationship together. Now, here's the fun part. Did I tell you I was bringing a sand ceremony on you?
I read it, but then I wasn't prepared to bring the star, but you got it.
You got it, girl. Okay, so which color do you want, sweetheart? I want you guys to stand over here.
I'll turn this side.
Okay.
This color.
And it should just twist off.
Just twist it off.
Okay, you guys can start pouring anytime you like. Your relationship is symbolized through the pouring of these two individual vessels. vessels of sand, symbolizing your lives and becoming a foundation of your life together. One represents you, Stephen, all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. And one represents you, Rachel, all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. Each container can own its own unique beauty, strength, and character. They can stand on their own and be whole without the need of anything else. When the two are blended together, they represent an entirely new and extraordinary love relationship. Each grain of sand brings to the mixture a lasting beauty that forever enriches the combination. Now the life that each of you have experienced until now, individually, will hereafter be inseparably united. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated, so will your marriage and your families be. So let this container be a constant reminder, along with what time?
6:58.
Nice job. Let this be a constant reminder. All right, you guys, come back around here.
That's not screwed on all the way.
No, that's okay. Almost. It was love that brought you here today. And it's love that makes yours a glorious union. And it will be love that makes your marriage endure. Love has given you wings, and your journey begins today. Wherever the wind may carry you, you will stay by each other's side. May there be truth and understanding between you. May you enjoy length of days, fulfillment of hopes, peace and contentment of mind. And may God bless you both, Stephen and Rachel, and keep you always, guiding you in your relationship so that it always flourishes and grows throughout a long and happy life together. And having expressed your love and commitment before God and your new family and friends here, right, Daisy? Right, Roscoe? Symbolized by the giving and receiving of rings, and in accordance with the laws of the state of Florida, I pronounce you're a husband and wife. You may seal your vows with a kiss.
Right.
What do you think, guys?
We had a lot of kisses.
Congratulations.
There you go. You want to hold the doggies and get a quick shot?
Here, I'll just take
care. And we had 2 minutes to go.
Oh, nice. Oh, that worked out well.
I'm about to cut that out because it's being recorded.
Oh, congratulations.
Sorry.
That part. Leave it in,
John. Let's go ahead and I'll put this little video in. You guys both kiss the dogs or whatever you want to do, just to let them know you got married officially.
There you go. Mr. and Mrs. Price.
So, and you gotta take their paw and say goodbye. Now, there you go.
Pour it up.
You're gonna hear a few clicks in there.
You have to do that fun little
around the.
You can do the wrap around. And move your move that thing.
I don't know if I can do
big old pipes.
Got these pythons.
Big guns.
When she was in her
20s.
Did you just
get her?
Or did you always
kind of
it? I like it.
Champagne, yeah.
It's the lost wax.
Now do
toast and
fun.
Like this.
Yeah, get in together.
Like through your other hand?
There you go. Get in.
And like do this?
There you go. Hold it out. There you go. Together.
We're very
excited. Now hold on. Kiss in the background.
Yeah. That's beautiful.
Got it. Boom.
It looks really good on you.
Oh, that's
nice.
So good.
God, we're
impressed. Yes. And really cool. Look at this one. Check this one out.
Oh, yeah, that's really good, too. Wow.
Oh, nice.
I love it. That's so good.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
You got to get the four. All right, that's it for that.
I want to make sure that you take, because I gained 10.
I see it in your eyes. You can feel it from my heart.
Bravo! All right, that is...